The last Slimeato album by NBA Youngboy will be his last album for a while, as NBA Youngboy's trial has officially been announced. On May 16th, rapper NBA Youngboy will face a grand jury and judge for his federal firearms court case. As reported by lawyers, the maximum prison sentence is 7 years. So obviously, NBA Youngboy will be trying to beat this case any way that he can. This court case begins on March 10th, 2021. The NBA Youngboy was charged with one count of possession of a firearm by a convicted felon, as well as one count of possession of a firearm that's not registered on the National Firearms Registration List, meaning that this firearm was bought illegally, whether it was on the streets or even from a close friend. Now, NBA Youngboy was out recording a music video out on a very public street in a neighborhood. An older lady who lives on the street calls the police as she was worried. Her description of what was going on was 10 to 15 men standing around a vehicle listening to loud music and flashing firearms around in the air. After law enforcement raided the scene, they realized that there was high-capacity magazines stuffed in these firearms that they were just flashing around. After his arrest, a judge ruled NBA Youngboy to be too reckless and dangerous as a human being to be released out into the free world. But they will allow NBA Youngboy to be released on house arrest. While on house arrest last year, NBA Youngboy was directed to bring himself into jail for his trial to begin. And well, the court case started, NBA Youngboy was a no-show. This means Youngboy had a warrant out for his arrest, and knowing his prior's record, law enforcement were not going to take this lightly. This means the FBI hopped on the case for the search for NBA Youngboy. Now, this search team was so big, they created their own operation team. In the court documents, it states that an operation team titled Never Free Again was created, with 15 to 20 agents, as well as a canine unit, as well as a helicopter if needed. Now, this search started by the FBI looking over the streets near NBA Youngboy's house, having a long stakeout waiting for him to leave his property. And well, they ended up finding him. NBA Youngboy then left his property driving in his SUV. The FBI agent then followed NBA Youngboy getting onto the highway. Now, at first, the FBI agent ended up directing NBA Youngboy to pull his SUV to the side of the highway. This is when the agent described NBA Youngboy pulling his car over to a complete stop. As soon as the FBI agent then stopped his vehicle and started opening up his door, NBA Youngboy then floored it down the highway. With Youngboy flooring it down the highway, ducking and weaving through traffic, it soon got too much and he had to drift off of the highway, hitting the regular streets. With NBA Youngboy having a very good lead on the FBI agent, he decided to pull his car over to the side of the road on the regular street and then take the chase on foot. As seen from video surveillance, NBA Youngboy was wearing designer shoes, skinny jeans, a jacket, as well as diamond chains, which is not the best outfit to wear from running from highly trained FBI agents. With the main agent who is chasing Youngboy alerting all of the other operation team members that Youngboy has now taken the chase on foot, all of the other agents created a perimeter circle around the area, meaning that all of the agents create a massive circle and they start closing in on NBA Youngboy by using canine units and even a helicopter so you can catch him easier. With a canine unit chasing down NBA Youngboy, he was forced to then hop a fence. Youngboy was then sprinting through a backyard, and it turns out this was a fan's backyard, who then pulls out his phone and starts taking video of NBA Youngboy sprinting away from an FBI agent. Now, Youngboy obviously ended up getting arrested by that agent. He was then taken into jail to await his trial. While waiting in jail, NBA Youngboy's lawyers were working around the clock, trying to get his trial pushed back, which is now May 16th, 2022, doing whatever and anything to get him released, with at the same time the feds creating the operation team to put Youngboy in prison for life. The battle ended up getting really tough. Now, this starts from NBA Youngboy being arrested around 14 to 16 times within the last few years. Now, when NBA Youngboy was told about the operation team, realizing that the feds want him in prison for a while, he released this message from behind bars. Now, I can leave my kids millions of dollars to divide, but I can't give them the time they truly deserve. Nobody understands me. They never did. Sometimes, I don't even understand myself. But that's okay, cause I'm fine. I ain't looking for you to feel sorry for me. I just ask for one thing, and that's for you to let me suffer in peace and tell Miss Wendy Williams I say she has a good soul and that she's a beautiful woman. I can see through all of the bad comments thrown at her. Tell her to count her blessings and stay in good spirits. Sincerely, NBA Youngboy. Now, shortly after this message, NBA Youngboy's lawyers worked out a deal to get him released on house arrest 3 months ago. When NBA Youngboy returned home, he went straight to work, releasing hit songs such as Safe Than Sorry, Bring the Hook, and No Switch. There was now reports of NBA Youngboy being taken back into jail already, awaiting his official May 16th trial. This could be due to the law enforcement not wanting to go through another high-speed chase, or it could be to him breaking his house arrest agreement in the last few weeks. Now, NBA Youngboy had lots to say about Lil Durk and many other rappers in the industry lately. With NBA Youngboy releasing his song titled I Hate Youngboy, the lyrics, they go as follows. Youngboy, they gon' get you, you better stop dissing them. Tell them guys, they know I ain't scared of them. How are you talking when nothing ain't gone about your cousin them? Quando got no filter, and he say that, they gon' get with them. Clean up on aisle O, youngin' let that blow. And my brother let that stick blow. No, that's mine, he called me a B. No, that's India, that be your girl. Now, I had to change a lot of the lyrics in that song, but you understand the point, as these lyrics are clearly a response towards Lil Durk, as Youngboy mentions Durk's cousin Nooski, and even says, clean up on aisle O, referring to the list of people from O Block that have been passing lately, such as D-Thang, Nooski, King Von, and a few others, sadly. Now, lastly, NBA Youngboy mentions Lil Durk's wife, India, calling her out for being a B, as Lil Durk ends up calling NBA Youngboy that same thing a few weeks ago. Now, NBA Youngboy has been going at Durk for weeks now. Even 3 weeks ago, Youngboy drops his song titled Bring the Hook, who is very obviously about King Von, as in those lyrics he says, this that Squid Game, O Block pack get rolled up, M what they told us, Atlanta boy get fold up. Now, King Von isn't from Atlanta, but he did sadly pass while in Atlanta, as King Von ran into Quando Rondo, otherwise known as a rapper, signed to NBA Youngboy's label. Now, with NBA Youngboy having a very good chance of serving a 7-year prison sentence due to the evidence against him, this will be his last album for quite some time, but it's also his last album signed under Atlantic Records, which is going to be very interesting. If you want more information on that, leave a like and don't forget to subscribe. I'm out. Peace.